Welcome to Today in America. A nation's strength comes from its communities where people live, work, and play. Here's one such place folks are proud to call home. From its uncompromising beauty to its unconquerable spirit, the city of Kenora's story is one of perseverance and success. Ontario's gateway from Western Canada, Kenora is located near the Ontario-Manitoba border in northwestern Ontario on the north shores of the Lake of the Woods.
The city of Kenora is about 15 to 16,000 people. Of course, that's a year-round population. In the summertime, that doubles with the summer residents, and with all the events in Kenora, will run up as high as 100,000 people.
Kenora's economy took a big hit in 2005 when its largest employer, an 80-year-old pulp and paper mill operation, announced that it was closing. Over 750 forest industry jobs were lost over the next 2 years. The mayor is a former mill worker.
Well, even though three mills closed and we lost a lot of jobs, the fact is Kenora is the most beautiful place on the face of the earth, and people don't want to leave here, they want to live here. So people got into business, they transitioned into a different lifestyle. People are retiring out of Winnipeg, out of other areas, moving here from all over the country. It's a beautiful place, it's a great team, we've got great people, and they're going to keep coming here.
Immediately following the announcement of the mill closure, the city hired an economic development officer and adopted an economic recovery strategy.
Because it's such a destination, people want to live and work here, and I mean, that's just what makes it great. So diversifying is a little easier. You know, the experts from the outside that are purchasing property in Kenora see this as having a phenomenal opportunity, and a lot of people from the outside, plus the people in Kenora, are reinvesting in this city.
Goals include job creation, increased assessment, and population growth. The primary areas of growth include business development, tourism, and special events, education and training, First Nation relationships, and economic infrastructure. Canada's sixth largest freshwater lake, the Lake of the Woods, is over 100 kilometers in length. Its 14,000 islands provides a unique boating experience for powerboats, sailboats, houseboats, kayaks, and canoes. Reevaluating its natural resources, the city recently initiated the Lake on the Woods project.
There's only one Lake of the Woods in the world. It's the most beautiful inland lake with over 14,522 islands. And one thing the First Nations have taught us that have been here for thousands of years is the fact that you have to protect your water. And I think we all feel that, and we've become the stewards of the lake.
Kenora native artist and writer Kimberly Cahoot is inspired by living on the lake.
Well, the lake is my muse here, and there's such inspiration all around me at all times. It really fosters creativity. And I find living in an intimate city has really fostered a spirit of sharing and collaboration. And the top-notch internet service we have here really does work well for me to sell my art worldwide.
Jay Pinner is a manager for one of Kenora's radio stations, Q104. He also calls Kenora home.
I took advantage of an opportunity to move to Kenora just over 2 years ago with my wife, and it was definitely the right opportunity. When you work as closely as I do with businesses and governments and organizations, you quickly get a true sense of the word community. Everyone is working together with the same goals and increasing an already booming summer economy and creating a place where everyone is proud to live and work every day of the year.
Harmony Red Sky and her daughter moved to Kenora from southern Ontario in 2010.
My husband had talked to me a lot about the culture and land and the water in the Kenora area. And it really, really sold me. And so it was those things that really drew us into coming here, to being a part of the community and to working hard for the community.
The community is excited about the $12 million downtown revitalization project.
The money that we've invested in Kenora at reinventing ourselves has brought in over $60 million in private sector investment. The White Cap Pavilion, the downtown revitalization, sprucing everything up, making you look like a real destination as we are, has just worked tremendously for the city of Kenora.
As early active cottagers market continues to grow, and as young professionals return home to raise their families, it's expected that Kenora will experience further growth as a destination and lifestyle community.